Uh-oh.
Yikes.
Oh, dear.
Uh-oh. What the heck's going on here, folks? Today was supposed to be the day that we were going to get invites for the March 23rd Apple event. Now, I say March 23rd Apple event as though it's common knowledge, as though it's going to happen, and that's because every single reputable leaker in the known universe was saying, yeah, March 23rd, watch out, here it comes. And, well, Apple sends their invites out a week in advance. It's now a week in advance of that date, and it is past the time that Apple sends out invites. So it looks like there will not be an event on March 23rd. And this is probably a little bit confusing to some of you, as it is to me. I've pulled up a list here of all of the product rumors that we've heard. It's quite a long list. AirTags, iPad Pro, an iPad Pro with mini LED, 24-inch iMac, 27 or 30-inch iMac with a new design generation, a new generation MacBook Pro, 14 and 16-inch versions, AirPods 3, a new Apple TV, iPad Mini, iPad Pro Mini, OLED iPads and MacBooks, Mac Pro Mini with like a G4 cube-shaped enclosure, an M1X powered Mac Mini with the same enclosure, a 10.8-inch iPad, HomePod Max, 15-inch MacBook Air, and that's basically it. That is a really long list, and obviously, to be fair, the further down the list, the more sort of speculative and early stages a lot of these rumors were, and obviously they weren't all expecting to come out in March. However, there were a couple of things that we were/are still expecting to see this month, and that is basically AirTags, iPad Pro, and maybe an updated iPad Mini. Now, one potential explanation as to why there were no event invites for March 23rd today is that March 23rd might be a significant event, but it might be a press release, in which case there would not be any invitations sent out. So it's possible that there is still an iPad Pro incoming, or, for example, AirPods 3 being announced, maybe even an Apple TV or an iPad Mini with an A14 chip. Those are all things that could still happen, but might just be in press release form rather than an event. It is definitely weird, though, and I understand the frustration if it's like, oh, well, everyone's been saying for like a month now that there was going to be an event on the 23rd, what's going on with that? Right now, in 2021, the rumors and leaks are kind of all over the place. None of the rumors and reports have really seemed as concrete as they normally are, and that was part of the reason why in my last video where I talked about the March event, I was sort of grappling with conflicting sets of information because it seems like no one can actually agree on what's happening. Now, I don't want to sound like indignant that Apple's not holding an event. This isn't a guaranteed thing. It's not like September, right? If Apple didn't hold an event in September, everyone would kind of lose their minds, but March is not a guaranteed thing, and even if it is, it's usually not that exciting. We usually don't get any real interesting hardware updates that we can sink our teeth into and review, so I guess it's not the most surprising thing, and realistically, at the end of the day, what I look forward to most about events is just the fun time of getting to watch them with you guys and hang out on the live stream. Ever since I started doing that last year, I absolutely love it. I want to continue doing it, and it's just a great time. So that's really the only thing that I would be bummed about. Realistically, if there's a press release or an event, it doesn't make a whole lot of difference, except for that I don't get to hang out with you guys on the live stream. So obviously I would have preferred an event, but let's be real here. These are consumer electronics products that can kind of come out whenever, and it doesn't really matter all that much. I guess the only case that you might be a little bit peeved about this is if you're trying to make a purchase decision and you want to know when would be a smart time to buy. So for example, if you have been looking to get a new iPad Pro, if you have like the pre-2018 model and you're thinking, huh, I kind of want to just get the newest one, then I would understand that you might be a little frustrated about a 2021 update to the iPad Pro. Now, if you have a 2018 iPad Pro, honestly, I don't think there's really any pressure to upgrade this cycle around because realistically, we're not looking at a redesign. We're not looking at anything like particularly insane. A14X, which is basically an M1 chip, is undoubtedly going to be a huge boost in power, but if you have an iPad Pro right now, a 2018 or a 2019, the A12X and Z are totally fine. And, you know, putting an M1 in an iPad is, in my opinion, a little bit unnecessary for what an iPad actually is. And then, of course, you've got mini LED displays, which have since been sort of clarified to be, we're expecting that on the 12.9-inch iPad Pro, not on the smaller 11-inch. So I suppose that could make sense. But if you're looking at an 11-inch iPad Pro, maybe you don't need to wait for that, right? So I would definitely say, you know, if you can buy a refurbished 2018 iPad Pro, that's what I have. I think it's awesome. You know, I think it's a great device. And it's not going to be completely outdated this time around. It's not a new design generation, new interface like we had in 2018. That was a major redesign. This is definitely not going to be that. And another totally fair area to be a little bit confused or maybe even frustrated would be if you absolutely need a new Mac right now. I've gotten dozens of comments and tweets and emails asking, you know, do I buy an M1 Mac or do I wait for M1X? Like, when do I do this? And it's totally fair to be confused by that, especially if you really need a new computer right now. And especially with a transition to Apple Silicon. With normal Intel refreshes, it's not really as big a deal. So I think, as I've said before, my big advice would be, if you need a computer right now, buy what you need right now. Especially if you're looking at the lower end M1 Macs, I don't think those are gonna be going away when M1X comes out, so buy those if you need them. They're still great. They're still absolutely ludicrous in terms of their performance and efficiency, so go for it. If you are buying like a 16-inch MacBook Pro and you already have like a 2019 15-inch MacBook Pro, that's where I would advise holding off. The longer you can afford to be patient, the longer you should be patient. Patience is key. These are, as I said, consumer electronics products. They're optional. It would definitely be a little foolish to get flustered and heated over not having the ability to give Apple a ton of money. You know what I mean? Anyway, that was a little bit of a tangent. This whole video was kind of informal because, you know, I had everything set up expecting March invites, but I guess, you know, as soon as I expect some news to happen, it doesn't happen. And of course, now that I've made this video, I wouldn't be surprised if I check my phone right now and there is an Apple event actually happening. There isn't. Good. This is a new one for me. Normally, when I make a video like this, there's instantly information that comes out that I would have loved to talk about in the video, and then I'm like, wow, great, nice. But that didn't happen this time. So yeah, a bit of an informal video. Definitely join me later in the week. I've got a couple other videos that are sort of waiting to go. I've got one that I'm working on right now that I think you guys are really going to enjoy. So definitely subscribe, follow me on Twitter at Luke Miani for updates. As usual, don't forget to comment and leave a like down below. And with that, I'll see you all in the next video.